Lisa Raitt wrote to the Commissioner for Federal Judicial Affairs to ask that he investigate these alleged leaks.
Now, Ms. Raitt, thanks for coming in. Tell me, first of all, why do you want these supposed leaks investigated?
Well, clearly it wasn't a supposed leak. It is a leak because that information regarding a Mr. Justice or a Chief Justice of Manitoba was not something that was in the public domain. This is something that would only be held in the Prime Minister's office or on the advisory committee that worked to provide the shortlist of candidates to the Prime Minister. This is a serious breach, Glenn. I mean, it doesn't get much more serious than having a Supreme Court of Canada appointment process be disclosed to the public when it really is never supposed to be disclosed.
Now, you've blamed the Prime Minister's office for this. You've gone on Twitter and said you thought it was coming from PMO. I know I didn't tell you who my sources were on this, and I very much doubt that Joan Bryden at the Canadian Press did either. How can you be certain this came from the Prime Minister's office and not somebody else?
Well, luckily, the amount of detail that both Hugh and Joan Bryden presented to the Canadian public was such that it would lead you to conclude that only somebody very close to the Prime Minister would have the knowledge that he went and did his own research on his own computer as to whether or not Mr. Joyal had any opinions out there or any kinds of speeches that would cause him to pause, and then told the story about how upset the Prime Minister was. Only somebody close to the Prime Minister can speak to the emotional status of the Prime Minister. Therefore, it had to come from somebody within the Prime Minister's office. That is very clear.
You've been in government before. You know how leaks work. Are you concerned at all that trying to uncover journalist sources will put a chill on political reporting and then ultimately leave the public less well-informed about things like the SNC-Lavalin case, for example?
Wow, Glenn, I think that's a ridiculous question, first of all, because what we're talking about is somebody who decided to leak information about a sitting Chief Justice of the Court of Manitoba in order to, I don't know, score a point on Jody Wilson-Raybould questioning her bona fides as a Liberal. This is a serious matter. I'm not asking you for your source. I'm assuming who your source is. You can keep your source to yourself, but I'd like to see the Prime Minister condemn what happened. I'd like to see an investigation into what happened and whether or not people understand the confidentiality that's needed around this process. And finally, I want to make sure that this stops. You know, starting tomorrow in a courtroom in Ottawa, Mark Norman is back in court defending the fact that he did not leak a cabinet confidence. I mean, this is crazy in terms of the amount of leaks coming out of this single government. We've got court cases going on. We've got Supreme Court justices and appointment process being questioned in the public. I mean, how do we have independence of our judiciary?
But the leaks seem to be coming from a lot of different directions. You say you're concerned about breach of confidentiality, but you haven't raised the same concerns about the leak to the Globe and Mail that triggered the SNC-Lavalin affair in the first place. Should that be investigated too?
Well, that's up to whoever wants to investigate that. What I'm interested in as the shadow minister who has the responsibility for justice is anything to do with hurting the judiciary and the independence of the judiciary. And I'll give you a prime example. What happens if somebody who comes from one of those affected communities that were named in the story that you did, LGBTQ community or somebody else with respect to the abortion community, what happens if somebody appears before this Chief Justice now? Are they going to assume that he's biased on the basis of what ended up happening? You know, I'm not looking to see who the source was. I want to see exactly how there was a breakdown in confidentiality in this matter and ensure that it doesn't happen again. And if the Prime Minister had something to do with it, then he should step up and take the responsibility for it.
These stories are giving us kind of the first insight into some of the behind-the-scenes machinations involving the selection of Supreme Court judges. And as you say, there's groups that could be potentially affected by these who have a vested interest in this. Does that not make the argument for a more open and transparent process? Should we possibly be doing what they do in the United States, where they have congressional committees that review judges? They go before them and are kind of vetted with their past decisions. Would you like to see that kind of openness here?
I understand what you're asking, but let me put it this way. This is the process that has been developed by this Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau. In the terms of reference for this advisory committee, there's a whole section on confidentiality, and it clearly states that when you're handling personal information, you're doing so in compliance with the Privacy Act. This is a serious matter, Glenn. This is something that transcends whatever we were talking about in SNC-Lavalin. Somebody has decided to breach a confidentiality that is so sacred that the Privacy Act comes to be part of it. And it happened possibly at the political level. I don't know for sure. My estimation based upon the reporting is that it did come from within the Prime Minister's office. We may never know where it comes from. Quite frankly, that doesn't matter. What matters is Canadians need to know that this government seems to be okay with leaking information with respect to matters that really should never see the light of day, because judges need to have assurances that they're going to be independent, and our judiciary needs to know that people who are choosing them are doing so on the right basis, instead of worrying about a U.S. style where we're going to be investigating people in terms of their bias.
Okay. Lisa Raitt, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.